All right, guys, welcome back to the farm. We got a little bit of running around to do before I can actually fertilize over there on 52 where the grass is. I need to make liquid fertilizer, and to do that, I need to get some stuff moved around. So first off, I'm going to grab the truck here. Now, this gold right here is glitched out. I need to go offload this truck, then come back and grab it, and then this plant will be fully operational. But I also need to go get gold from the stone processor, and then I also need to go grab a trailer, a liquid trailer, and run that over to the gold plant, pick up the slurry that's there, bring that back down to the fertilizer, drop that off so I can produce more fertilizer. I need to get stone from the gold plant, bring that down to the stone processor, grab some lime. In fact, I forgot to look. Do I have lime available? Let's see. Stone processing. Yes, I do have some lime. So I gotta get lime down to the liquid fertilizer, drop off water there. That way I can get liquid fertilizer going and I can fertilize field 52. I don't think that's gonna get all done here in this episode, but at least you guys can go along with me here and as I get all that ready to go. I have not sold off the hemp yet. The hemp, I just looked over at the South Railroad Mill, was still at 350,000 out of 500,000, so really not worth taking a train load over there, so I'm going to hold off on that one. That will get sold here eventually. I still haven't quite decided what to do with the corn or the wheat that I harvested, and I still also have to go and pick up the wheat that I dropped over on the field over there at the Wright Farm. So still a lot of stuff to get done here, and you know, I'm not expecting snow. I know I've talked about that before, because I think the seasons, the days that I have, you know, set up here, it doesn't get cold enough for the snow to fall. I've had some people say that the snow map doesn't work on this, that you know, it doesn't snow at all. I've had others say it does, so we're not going to find out here, most likely. I do not expect that to happen, but you know, for those who do go longer, maybe you want to see snow. If you've got it set up to 6-day seasons instead of 3, maybe it will snow. You guys can let me know. I know Cass has talked to me about it in the past, and I think there is a snow mask, so there should be snow on the ground if that does happen. Oh, he put in a regular ramp here. Nice. So the map did get a small update. I don't know if I mentioned that. I know I had said that there could be or there will be an update soon. It did get an update this week, or last week actually, and it's just mainly cosmetic stuff. That's all it really is. So it's not going to be a game breaker for you guys. You're not going to have to reset the map or anything like that. Just go ahead and delete the old map, download the new one from the server link that is down below in the description, and then, or from his link, the Google Drive link that I will put, I believe is down there as well. I'll make sure it's down there, so, you know, either or, and then you guys can just go ahead and replace that in your mods folder, and boom, you're done. There really weren't a whole lot of changes, so it's just, like I said before, it's just basically cosmetic. We're cleaning up stuff here and there that we're seeing, and getting things just, you know, looking all pretty. That's all it is, with floating trees or, you know, things like that. You know, nothing major. Nope, not loaded yet. How about now? No? This is a tricky one. There it is. 1767. Almost to 1776. Y'all should know, or at least the Americans should know, the significance of 1776. So it's also been mentioned a couple of times, and also recently, about console players. I still haven't quite figured out a good way to set up a contest for you guys. And on top of that, I don't even know how I would get a copy of the game to you. I do have PS4, and that's it. I've never done anything with Xbox. You know, and the game is $35, so that rules out gift cards. So I haven't quite figured out how to do that. Yeah. I mean, if anyone's got ideas about how maybe they saw someone do it, please, by all means, let me know down there in the comments. It's, you know, normally mentioning other streamers, unless that person has already been, you know, collaborating with that streamer, is a faux pas. It's not something you do, you know? You don't go on to, you know, say Digger Wan and say, hey, you should check out Casket Man, or, you know, or Casket Man does this, and then whatever. You don't do that. That's a no-no. But if Mr. Moose and I are playing the same game, or have played the same game, that's going to be a little different, because Mr. Moose and I have played, like, 7 Days to Die, for example. So that's a little different. Still, some YouTubers do frown upon that, but in my opinion, that's fine. You know, ATS videos. Hey, you know, Full Tilt or Full Tilted did this. Well, okay, I don't care. You know, nothing against Full Tilted. You know, him and I think are pretty much the only ones that are doing regular ATS videos. Yeah, there's a couple others like Faviano and. But I mean, as far as, you know, higher subscriber numbers, Squirrel as well, but, you know, I'm getting off the point here. You know, no one's gonna go over into his channel and say, hey, Caskman does this or whatever, just like no one's gonna come over into my channel and say, hey, Full Tilted did this, you know, that's usually frowned upon. You know, you don't do that, so. I completely lost track of where I was going with all that. But anyway, yeah, no, I remember now. So yeah, if you guys have seen someone do a video, it doesn't matter who they are or what game they did it with. And now remember, they have to be on PC to do it. So let me know how they did it, and I'll take a look at it. But I still haven't quite figured out a legit way to do it. To where someone else that just comes along and, you know, watches 5 minutes of a video for the first time and enters and ends up winning. You know, that's not fair. And I'm sure many of you would agree. You know, many of you would agree to that. But I really don't think, you know, see, there was no gold there. It was just glitched out. I really don't think there's a way around that. Is there? Am I wrong? I mean, obviously, the best thing to do is still watch the Twitch streams. That's still the best way to go about entering into a contest that I'm going to be doing here for ATS Oregon. Well, everyone's going to have PC anyway for that. But Farm Sim 19. There is a website, I think. It's Glimmer or something like that, a Gleam or whatever. I could probably try that. Set up a contest, and I don't know where I'm going with this. I don't need it for anything. I did what I needed to do. I'm just, like, aimlessly driving now. So I'll just park this thing over here. Now I need to go get this truck, and no, that's not a truck, but it's a tractor. It gets me close enough. I'm going to take this truck, and I think I might upgrade it. I might upgrade this to the CRT, the Custom Road Trains truck. Yeah, I think Gleam I might be able to use here, so I'm going to look into it. I'm definitely going to look into it. Since the bulk of those of you who watch the videos here, watch the series, are PC players, obviously that stuff's still going to be centered around PC players, but as for the consoles, yeah, I could, you know, if I can work out a good way, then Yeah, I don't rule out giving away, you know, maybe 5 copies.
Oh.
Maybe 5 copies of Farm Sim 19 on console. It's just going to be the question of, okay, how do I do that? Do I, you know, like I was just saying, you know, do I buy, and how do I buy the game and get it to you guys, or do I end up PayPaling you $35? Bottom line, that might be the best way to do it. If someone sets up a PayPal account, links it to a bank account or whatever, and I send you the $35 that way, you know, I have no idea. So I'll have to figure something out here. But I do want to do something for you guys over here who are console players. I really do. And I got console players that watch over on Twitch as well, so, you know, YouTube are not the only ones. Just kind of watching this trailer here, it does seem to be a little twitchy. Now it's not gonna do it. Oh, there it goes a little bit. Every time, if I just turned ever so slightly, it does start to get a little twitchy back there. Yeah, I think it's time to go ahead and get rid of this truck. I can get the CRT truck and use it for double duty, so I can use it to haul this trailer, to haul around the roll-offs, and then I'll have a hitch on the back so I can haul other trailers. That'll work, right? So, repair, and sell. Alright. Pick up a new truck. Now, see, there is the option of just getting one of these. Can I put a... and trailer hitch? I can. So, which one do I go with? I'm gonna put hitches on that one. Maybe this one. Ooh, 200. Ouch. 210 for that one. Oh, by the way, the Kenworth has finally been updated, so if you guys haven't done so, or if you did already, make sure you jump onto the server list link that's down there in the description and re-download the 880. This particle effect, if you look closely here, that's on the lights and the headlights and everything, gone. Cass also changed the engine sound too, so it matches the 389 engine sound. So, much nicer and less annoying with that stupid particle effect. Okay, so we got 269 for that one. We got 210 for that one. 195 and then 132. Maybe I'll try this one. So, we'll put a trailer hitch on here. Main colors. Just go ahead and make that green. We'll do wide tires and then we'll do black rims. Only $134,000 for this thing. So, hopefully it's good. We're about to find out. Now, that also means I don't need that trailer anymore. Alright, over to the concrete plant. Can I lift that axle? I don't think so. Nope, because X extends that out. V doesn't do it. And Z doesn't do it either, so. Cannot lift up the axle. Just feels like it turns a little weird. I'll have to double check. I do not know if this truck is on the server. It might be. In fact, well, this is the first time I've ever used this truck, so... Looks good with that tanker on there. Real bouncy. Suspension feels pretty tight, pretty stiff. Liquid fertilizer for you soon. Don't you fret. This fog has been here all day. It was here. This is the same day that I was harvesting, so it's still day two, mid-autumn. It was here all morning when I was harvesting, and it's still here. It has not gone away yet. Kinda sucks, man. All right, let me get this trailer out of here. Bring that back up at a gold plant. How are we doing on the hemp? Has it gone down yet? Nope, only went up 400,000 now. You're killing me. Killing me, man. I need to come up here and get these trees out of here. does look like it's starting to give way a little bit. I can see a little further. So maybe the fog is starting to lift. Alright, so I'll leave you here. Load up in this little bit of slurry. I have no stone. Oh, well, it doesn't matter. I have lime anyway, so we're good. Let me go get that truck. That loads up with a slurry. I'll take this one over. Load him up with lime, and then we'll be good to go. Thank goodness. The fog is gone. Yay! Where is it? Right there. Second one right here. Well, that loads up. Let me grab this guy. You're loaded up. Yep. Not a whole lot, but it's enough to produce some more fertilizer, and that's the key. Need to keep fertilizer getting produced. Leave you right here, kind of just completely plast. Or full, good. Now on 15, there was a lime spreader truck for Farm Sim 15, but I have not seen a lime spreading truck for 17 here. Has anyone seen one of those before? All right, can you go in to follow me? Yes, you can. Going faster than he is. Come on, guy. Keep up. Game save. So nice that that ramp is down there now. So much nicer. You know I have a wheel, there are still times I'll sit here and use the keyboard. I'm smelling a photo opportunity. That'll work. Alright, so Lime, you need to go right over here. Or no, Slurry. I'll offload him and then jump him over to the water spout that I just put in over there, and then I'll fill him up with water so I can dump it off in there. Excellent. Fertilizer or lime. Here we go. I love the swaying shadows of the trees. That is just one little touch, you know? It's sometimes the little details that really do it. And you're still loading up. Only 13,000? Holy crap. Alright, what do I need over here at the farm? Actually, seeds and fertilizer. Thank you. Well, it came down a little bit, but still, that's not enough for me to really make it worth my time. That's like one train car. That's only one train car of hemp over to the mill. And you know what? Beggars can't be choosers, and push comes to shove here, I'll probably just end up taking the one train car over there. I'd rather do it all in one shot, but... I also can't forget there is corn and wheat that I can go ahead and sell off too. Now, wheat is not going to really bring back a whole lot of money. Corn will do okay over at the North Railroad Mill, because that's almost $1,000 a liter. Or $1,000 per 1,000. So that's paying out pretty good. But there is still the idea of holding on to the corn and use that for cows or pigs. Get back over there and grab the seed, and he's probably still going to be filling up. Now, in order to clear this grass, I think Cass said you just need to cultivate, and the gravel will show up, the grass will disappear. But also, speaking of the giveaways earlier, what looks like I'm going to end up doing here is I will end up buying copies through Giants, and I will have those copies sent to me. Now, all I'll need from you guys is when you're over on Twitch, and if you do win a raffle, all you have to do is just give me your email address. So when that activation code comes in the email to me, which only takes a couple of minutes, I will be able to copy it and mail one off to you. So, I'll explain that also in the Twitch streams. But that's going to be pretty simple. I wasn't sure if I was going to have to put in someone else's name or information and do all that. But I think that's the easiest way to do it. Hopefully it all works out. He's dropping off the water. That'll take a couple minutes. So let's go run this back over to the farm, and we are set. He will start producing liquid fertilizer, so next episode I should be able to go ahead and take care of that field over there. At field 52. Oh, come on, turn. Got distracted by the phone here. Put him back, and we'll be good to go. How are we doing on the hemp? 285, we're dropping. We are dropping. That's now almost two train cars. No. No, it's not. Because one train car at 120 will put us at 400,000. Yeah, that's almost. Shut you down and check on you over here. Off. Oh, we're still offloading. I'm still offloading. Holy crap, man. Someone make a bigger hole on this thing. Jeez. That takes forever. Oh, man. Yeah, so let's get some cultivating going. I might just go ahead and hire a worker for this one. I might try course play again. I don't see a reason to use course play on this though. Hired help does just fine. Finally offloaded. Now wait a little longer. 18 and change, that's not quite enough to fill the whole machine up, so. I mean, it's plenty probably to do 52. That's probably plenty. Double check over here at 285. You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and jump into. Is this the one I want? Yes. Jump out. No, let it go. Whoa, wait. There was a coin over here. There it is. It's been said I should go for all the coins. That is something I have never done. I have no idea where the hell they're all at. That would take forever. And there's no bonus for finding all the coins, I believe. And they don't help you with your rep either. They did in the past on Rivers for Farm Sim 15. The more coins you found, I think you could actually use them to purchase for factories or fields. I think it was one or the other. or it helped you in some way. Here, I don't believe finding the gold coins do anything for you. I could see that maybe they increase your chances of a bid being accepted. But is that really worth trying to find all the gold coins? I don't think so. Find a handful of them, you know, it all depends on the dynamic there. But I haven't heard much about how all that is set up here for 17 and the map and everything, so that's why I really haven't stressed going for gold coins. Sure as hell doesn't feel like I'm doing 51 miles an hour. See if I can make a quick buck here before wrapping things up. I'll have to figure out what I'm gonna do for next season. What shall I plant? I don't have any factories to worry about. I could probably do hemp or mustard. Those are good selling crops. I've seen railroad tracks on the new maps for FarmSim 19, but I haven't seen trains yet. Has anyone seen photos of trains? It'd be interesting to see what they do. You know, we had the American style map over here for Goldcrest Valley, but that was a European train. So hopefully they put some American style trains and cars in. I mean, for me, that kind of just rubs me in the wrong way sometimes. You know, they it'd be like ETS2 or you know, SCS with American Truck Simulator, putting in European cars or European trailers. You know, you're showing an American game or an American map, and you're putting European stuff in it. All right, there's one load. Yep, we're not gonna get the whole thing in there. 404,999 out of 500. But I made 265 off of that one. So we'll at least dump what we can into here. I'll have to come back and get the rest. So we'll shut that down for now. Of course, that will start up and start driving around when I reload the map. So there we go. We're up to $583,000. Let's pick up some fields here, shall we? Which ones? I'm kind of thinking 11 because of the sheep. The sheep pastures right here. If I pick up 11, turn all into grass, that is more than enough. But I kind of don't want to, though, because I do have 52. I do have field 52. And if I buy another field over here, like say 53, I can turn this into chaff. So plant corn, chaff it all. End of story. And that's plenty of grass. I can probably get 2 cuttings in a season out of this, if I do it right. I'll probably be able to get 1 more here before winter comes in. Maybe. Let's see. It's not going to show me what the crop growth is. Yeah, it's not going to show me the growth. I might be able to get 1 more cutting in. Maybe do that on day 3 here. But then again, getting more fields over here would be ideal. I don't want to buy this one yet because it's got cotton on it. I like the cotton to go away. I do not have anything to harvest cotton, so I think I will leave that be. What is this one? Ooh, I can actually do a mission on this one. He wants me to plant, huh? $275,000 for this field. This little one over here is 170. And this one is, it's got corn on it too. I can harvest that right now. 324. It's high because it's got crop on there that can be harvested. That's kind of, what's this one? Field 40. Sorghum. Maybe I'll do some missions in the upcoming episodes, but for now, ooh, how much is 41? I've never bought 41. $640,000. Let's see. What was this? This was potatoes, wasn't it? Yeah. Mustard? Alright. 169,000. Alright, so I think I'll buy this one. So now I have that mustard to harvest. And do I have enough money for field 39? Yes. So now I've got mustard and corn to get harvested. I'll do that for tomorrow, for day 3. And that will get me a few more items to sell. I need to fertilize both of these as well, so I need to get the fertilizer down here, take care of that. So two more fields to harvest. That will definitely help in the overall scheme of things. Now I'm at the 19 points. Getting there. I need 20. And so what I can do here is when I sell off more of the hemp, then I'll be good in that aspect as well. We're still at 420. It just dropped again, so let me jump back into the train and offload. There we go, $144,000. So, I'm gonna run this train back. You know what? Forget it, no. I'll just send it on its way. Go back to autopilot on you. So we got more work to do. I have to go lease a combine again. I need to get the head from Cook and bring it over here to do 39, and then I need to run it back over here with the header, which is over here at Wright Farm, and harvest the mustard that's over there. So a little bit of work to do. Let's double check one last time here on this guy. Oh yeah, 4,500. There we go. Now we're good. Now we're cooking. That's enough to fill that fertilizer up. Let's run back up there to the Johnson farm, offload, and get ready to fertilize. That's right, just dump it on the ground. That's fine. You know what? I'll use this guy. What was the change? And left control B. Drop off that. Alright, so I'm going to get these filled up, and we'll run over to the field. I'll start fertilizing, but that's where I'll end up running. I'll cut out here. We're getting up to the time where I like to sign off anyway, so... Plus, I also need to get ready to leave, so... Come on, where is it? Oh, wait. Gotta be on the right one. Gotta have it selected, you idiot. You damn fool. That was quick. That filled up quick. Oh, he's still going. Okay. I'm like, what is he plowing still? The case is still plowing, and I'm thinking, wait a minute, that field should be done. Hopefully he's not doing something else. Alright, so we'll start off on this field here. You know what? Maybe I'll try a course play. Do I have one saved? Field 52. Spray. Nah, I don't like that one. No headland is needed. I think we're good. Generate course. There we go. And drive. Drive now. Wrong tool for this mode. Oh, there it is. Why are you folding up? That was... That made complete total sense right there. Let's fold up, move 6 feet, and then unfold again. At least this one isn't gonna screw up. So, alright, I'm gonna wrap this up here, guys. Thank you all for watching. Hopefully you did enjoy. If you did, slap that like button. If you didn't, do the opposite. Don't forget to get subscribed here on YouTube. Also, make sure you check down in the description for links to Facebook, Twitter, Twitch, Discord, join in on the chat. Keep up to date on the information that what I'm doing, when I'm doing it. As well as check out the mods list that's down there linked to the server mods list. Many of what I have here is over there, so you guys can go ahead and download that. The map as well. The map link is down there too. So, I think that's it for now. I will catch you guys next time here on the farm, where it'll be day 3 of autumn, and we're going to get some harvesting done, hopefully make some more money, and get ready for the fall. Until then, take it easy.